I think going back and looking at the tactics from some of the performances over the course of the last 2 years, I mean, the best performances have been, I mean, the Denmark semi-final, four at the back, Ukraine in Rome, four, the Czech Republic game, four, the Croatia match, the opening of the European Championships, four. The Germany game was an outlier in the fact they played three in that match, and then in the final they played that match. But for every other game in the tournament, they played with four at the back.
Well, I even remember going, as far back as when we went to Spain and beat them on the counter playing four at the back, if I remember correctly. And
what year was that?
That was in the Nations League, was it?
It was in the Nations League 2018, is that right?
Yeah, sounds about right.
Away from home, 4-3-3, yeah.
Can I ask you an honest question, Danny? And I'm not in any way belittling the job that Gareth Southgate has done, because...
Which means he's about to.
He's taken an England team to a World Cup semi-final, a World Cup semi-final that I think, had he been braver, they'd have won. Had he been more proactive with his substitutions, I think they'd have won. He took them to a European Championship final, which again I think was a golden opportunity to win. He has restored the faith of England fans in the national team. There is no longer this disconnect between players and supporters, players and media. But do you envisage a situation where Gareth Southgate is going to lift a major trophy at international level as a manager? I don't think he's got the quality to do that.
I'd look at it a different way before I answer that. And I think there's a chance he can because of the quality we've got. But do you think, because I don't think that we would have been anywhere near, I don't think we'd have had a semi-final and a final and been that close to winning two big tournaments if anyone else would have been doing the job.
Do you think if Sam Allardyce had continued in his job that they would have achieved what they've achieved?
No, I don't. So I'm not belittling his achievements.
No, you're not. You're asking a valid question.
But you're being binary in the fact that you're suggesting that if it had been a different manager, then they would have gone on and won those tournaments because ultimately he didn't make the right tactical decisions.
Yeah,
so you are saying that.
I think with an elite-level manager...
Yeah, but then what you have to ask yourself is this spirit we've now got as a group, the discipline, the kind of feel-good factor amongst the group, players wanting to play for the country again, this bringing younger players through, this kind of nice balance we've got, everything he's created away from on the pitch.
Yeah,
I'm not
Fantastic.
Sure anyone I'm not sure
also,
anyone else could have done.
It's very easy to say, oh, they should have done this with hindsight, or they should have done that with hindsight.
Correct,
aren't you actually also belittling the abilities of Luka Modric, Marco Verratti, some of the other players that they've come up against during those tournaments? If you look at 2018, the Croatia side that they played was dripping with talent. You know,
they got an absolute pasting in the final.
Because France were a very, very good football team that had been together for a very long time and had some of the best players in the world. Kylian Mbappe, Paul Pogba, who thrives in international football.
Do you think man for man, that Croatia team was better than the England team they faced in the semi-final?
Yeah, I do. Yeah, I think they were better. Not necessarily man for man, but I think they were better players in certain positions which allowed them to express themselves in a different way.
They had wisdom
in
the middle of the park.
Had Luka Modric, who is basically one of the best players that has played for Croatia in 20 years.
Yeah, but the other thing, Sam, is what you're looking at from 18 is I think lessons were learned. I really do. Because I actually think a lot of the decisions made in the Euros just gone were clever and actually bold. And although in the final I agree, and I understand why you hang on when you 1-0 and you think, well, I won't change it because we're winning.
Yeah, but they get the second goal. I agree.
But they didn't get the second. But, they didn't get the second goal, nor did Italy. And ultimately, they did bring on a substitution after, what was it, 71 minutes they brought Saka in, 74 minutes they brought Henderson in with 15 minutes to go.
But what about the... So when we look at the first game they won in the tournament, yeah, and even I was a bit, why is he playing Trippier left back? And he did, and he went
with
it.
Yeah, it
worked. Then he brought Saka in out of the blue. Everyone was talking about the front three leading up, who's going to play. No one even mentioned him. Mm. He brought him in for a big game and put him in there, and the next thing, he's flying. He changed to a three for the Germany game, got the game won. Some of his big decisions, if he hadn't made, you can analyse and go, he should have done this. He made a lot of good ones.
Just mention the minutes of those changes again.
71 and 74.
By the 71st minute, Italy had taken control. Should have reacted much earlier.
But England got it back for the last 20 minutes when Henderson came on the pitch.
Yeah, but should have made it earlier.
When? How much earlier?
But the fact you're debating this, means that a lot of people will be thinking in the camp of saying, you know, someone else could have done better, and some will be going...
But the point is...
Let me finish. Some will actually be the other way going, he's done a remarkable job to get us to a point where we're even having this conversation.
Jim White and Simon Jordan. Monday to Friday mornings from 10 on AM, on DAB, via the TalkSport app and on your smart speaker. TalkSport.